Hi and welcome back to another Mixed Media Tuesday. As promised, I will be playing and sharing lots of ideas on how you can use products from my latest collection. And today I'm going for a layout on one of my ring journal pages. I chose to go with this one just because I'm going to use as my focal point the gramophone from my Ephemera, and I thought that having those notes was perfect for the theme. So if you watched the video that I posted last week, I shared a 7 steps recipe for beginners which works every time. And today I'm going to follow those steps and come up with a new page, just to show you that it works beautifully. So first I'm starting by using 2 dye ink pads for the background. I'm using first the burgundy color, and I'm starting by applying the color with my brush just because it gives that subtle look, and then I can always oversaturate areas by using another blending tool with a foam. So the products that I'm playing with today are from my Create Happiness collection with Stamperia. This is the second collection where you will find products like rub-ons and Ephemera that have a lovely vintage look with fall colors. Here I switch to the coffee dye ink, and this is the perfect color to add that extra brown touch that will turn any background into vintage looking. I'm staying mainly at the edges, and you can blend a little bit at the center just to give a more coherent look. Don't worry about having the perfect blending. You can see mine isn't perfect, but after doing all the techniques for the background, your eyes will not be able to see those imperfections. Actually, they will add more into that visual texture that we're going for the background. And I'm following my 7 steps. So first step was to ink up a couple of colors for the background. Second step, to add splashes. So here I'm adding water splashes first. I'm going to blot the extra water, and you can see that beautiful design that you get. The darker the color and the more saturated it is, the more visible those splashes are going to be, and also as they dry, they will become even more visible. Now I'm also going to add some brown splashes. Again, I just swiped my coffee dye ink on top of my glass, and with a little bit of water, it's super easy to do. Step 3 is stenciling, and here is a stencil from my latest collection that gives you a lovely design. Now my background already has notes at the back, so you don't really need to use that part, or you can even add a little bit here and there just to enhance that idea, which is something that I will do later on. But at the same time, there are a couple of lovely borders here on the corners, and these are the ones that I am going for to create borders on a couple of corners for my page. If you want a really vibrant background that stands out, you can go with black ink. However, I wanted a more subtle look that blends lively with the rest of the colors already in my background. That's why I went with coffee dye ink, and I'm going to add a little bit on the other corner. And I'm also going to add some of those notes here and there, not all over the place, just to enhance the design that is already there on my background. These steps are really mess-free. Remember, the dye inks do not stain stamps or stencils, so you can see I just spray a little bit of water on top of the stencil and it's as brand new. Here I'm going back to step number 1. I thought that I didn't ink up the edges as much as I wanted, so I'm going back with my blending tool all over the edge to make it a little bit darker, again using the same coffee color that I used for the rest of the page. And I'm going to work on my focal points. This is the Ephemera pack from my latest collection, and for today I'm going with the gramophone, and I will combine it with one of the cats just because I thought it was super cute. So here is Ginger on my page. I'm inking up the edges just to get rid of that white edge, and I do that on pretty much every Ephemera that I use. I just sometimes don't show it on camera. And then with my craft knife, I'm going to go around that line and create a little slit. The idea is to be able to tuck inside flowers and leaves from the Ephemera pack as if they are coming from inside the gramophone. So if you follow my 7 steps recipe, you need to first do the background by using a couple of ink colors, then add splatters, then move on and use your stencils, and then step 4, do some stamping for your background. Or you can switch 3 and 4 if you like. However, here if you noticed, I didn't do any stamping, just to show you that you don't have to follow those steps in the same order. And of course you can omit steps or do something completely different. They were just a few steps that I put together to help beginners who just want to start now. So this is step 5, where you play with ephemera, with cutouts, your scrapbook papers to create a cluster and put together your focal point. And as I'm putting together my focal point, I'm going to chat a little bit about my whereabouts. So I am filming this about 10 days earlier, and this is going to be a scheduled video. It is going to go up and for you to see while I will be traveling back from the US to Greece. And if everything goes as planned, I will be home late evening of Tuesday. And I am planning to share lots of photos and videos of my whereabouts while I will be in Dallas for the workshop. So if you do follow my Instagram and maybe Facebook account, then you will definitely see photos of what I'm doing there. Hopefully I won't be too excited to forget completely about that. But maybe I can put together a video later on to show you how it was. Let me know in the comments below if you would like to see that. Now here I'm going back to one of the steps that I missed doing, and that was stamping in the background. And I did that because in the beginning I thought it wasn't necessary. However, after seeing the whole composition, I thought that a little bit of stamping at the background would add even more interest at the background. After all, I have a lot of blank space. So I'm using stamps from my Elements stamp set. This is from my first collection. And I'm using black for that. The next step is to play with white, so here I'm using my white gel pen and adding some highlights here and there, mainly on the cutouts. This is going to help them stand out a little bit more. And before I go ahead and add the white splashes, I'm just going to add a few of those golden pearls as if they are coming out of the gramophone, along with the leaves and the flowers. I think it is a fun touch and it adds even more to the whole idea, plus you end up with kind of a different texture. They are dimensional and of course they are shiny. And I'm still at step number 6, where I'm adding white. First the white highlights with a white gel pen, and now with a brush and calligraphy ink, just adding splatters all over the place. And then let's move on to step number 7, which is the last. Sometimes for my quotes I like to print them out using my label maker, it's super handy as well. And then I did buy a new refill that prints white on top of black, and I am in love with this one. And these are really easy to peel off. I'm going to place them down, and then with my white gel pen I'm just going to outline them. And I'm going to call this page done. I'm going to share a few close-up photos just like always, so you can see the details better. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Remember, links are down below in the description. Thank you all for joining me, and I'll see you all next time.